All right, guys. Jordan and I have been waiting on this for quite a while, and it's gonna be pretty cool. I mean, we've been doing this YouTube stuff for a pretty long time, and YouTube actually just sent us an email saying this was coming, so pretty cool. Let's go inside and we'll check it out here. Hi, buddy. All right. Jordan is manning the couch, as you can see. But I think this will be pretty cool, huh?
Oh, yeah.
We've been waiting on that for quite a while. How long have we been doing it? About 9 years?
Yeah, around that.
Yeah.
I was little.
Yeah.
Like 13.
Wow. So. Yeah, it has been a long time coming, that's for sure. I suppose we should find something to open this thing. This will work. All right, luckily we had this little knife from our friend Wally in the whole kitchen there. So you wanna hold this while I open it?
Not really.
No? Hey, let's actually try this. Let's see if this actually works. Hold tight. This could be a trip to the emergency room.
Health insurance.
Watch your wrists. Oh, I'm a little shaky.
I see that.
What do you think? Did it get it?
You got one more.
Alright. Oh no. Oh, I did it. Game of Thrones style.
Should have shot it.
Hopefully I don't eviscerate you in the process. Okay, anyway. Let me put the sword down and then Jordan can open this. Alright, the sword is safely put away and we're going to take a look at this thing. It's pretty exciting for us, really. We've been doing this since like March of 2010 and we've been waiting on this thing for quite a while.
Yeah, it's been a pretty long time since I was in middle school.
Let me give you a little, you know, letter, congratulations and all that.
These look completely different from how they used to.
Oh, man. These used to be so cool because you get like a big, heavy, you know, silver button. And they've had to obviously cut back a bit. But, you know, it makes sense because it's such a gigantic company. You've got millions upon millions of channels. And as years go by, obviously, you're going to have more and more people hitting 100,000 subscribers. So it makes sense to me that they couldn't, you know, afford to keep making... you know, the big giant buttons and everything, but
it still looks pretty cool though.
I'm still you know, it's more of a symbol than anything. I'm not so concerned of what it's made out of or anything. It's just cool. It makes you feel like a real YouTuber, you know. You can go ahead and get out of the plastic if you want.
It's just for passing 100,000.
Yeah, but and honestly, we probably should have hit 100,000 a long time ago, given our views. I mean, right now we're at like 75 million plus views, and usually by then you would have 200,000 or 300,000. But we've never been the type of people to like do the
ask for
yeah, please subscribe and all that during every video, you know,
which was probably a mistake.
It was stupid.
But whatever,
but it does look cool, you know.
I still like it. I know they, you know,
so even got our channel name on there. It's still a pretty quality piece, you know. I think it's pretty neat.
Even for changing it up, it's still pretty cool.
And honestly, I've heard of stories of people waiting months and months and months. I will give you a little tip, whether they want me to or not, is I think they want you to basically wait until they message you through your creator studio and let you know that you're getting it. I would recommend dropping a little email to them, which is what I did, and I said, hey, you know, we've been over 100,000 for a while here and we got X amount of views. Is there anything I need to do on my end to make sure I get the silver play button? And I think that sped things along because
they were like, oh yeah, you should already have it. And then they sent it in the mail in what, 2 days?
Yeah, literally they mailed it real quick. It was here in about a week, which is pretty awesome, I think. And we're psyched about it, and you know, it's been a lot of, you know, what, 2,300 videos. Yeah, we've been doing this, like he said, you know, you if you watch the channel, you pretty much watch him grow up, you know.
I went from being a middle school student, however old I was, to a 24-year-old now, so.
We've had a lot of projects and things like that.
Some of those projects were for my school.
But we need to figure out where we're going to hang this thing, which also brought me to this. I thought we've never actually showed you, like, kind of rambling around headquarters here. And Jordan straightening pictures.
Well,
he has a touch of OCD. But so we thought we'd give you a look around where we work. This is actually where we do all the editing and everything. And I think Jordan's done a pretty good job of setting up all the technology and all that. That's definitely not my end of things. I know how to edit and I know how to use cameras, and that's about it. Everything else, Jordan took care of everything. But we thought we'd give you a little look around here.
We have two pretty good computers. They're both for different things. Right now, this is mainly where he's working. He's got a 40-inch monitor, and then he's got a computer that has been upgraded a little bit. It's capable of doing 1080p, 60 hertz. He's got a bunch of multi-terabyte drives there so we can store the videos to keep the computer running fast.
Yeah, we, you know, storage is important when you're doing video. So these are all terabyte drives stacked up here, and we've got a bunch of them. But, you know, between doing videos for Country Classic Cars and Mans, and kept a lot of the videos, obviously, all the videos, like from Fastlane and Gateway, it ends up being a whole lot. And then actually, as the video quality improved, the files got even bigger.
Yeah.
So, you know, you need more and more storage.
Higher quality video is going to eat up more space.
When it came to putting this place together, a lot of the things, you know, really searched around and found, or we actually made the things that are in here, which makes it a little more interesting, I think. Actually, the desk here is a 100-plus-year-old sewing machine. It even still works. You can actually step on this, and it pumps that wheel right there that would run the sewing machine. But anyway, I just thought it was kind of neat, and just put a wood top on it and everything. That's something interesting. And then Jordan found this cool chair that's basically like a bucket seat out of a car. That's pretty comfortable to work in, I'll tell you. And that wasn't too much money, really. And then Jordan and I are always out looking around like little flea markets and antique malls and whatever. And we pick up like little things just to lay around. This is like a little Mark's wind-up toy. Kind of cool. And then this is actually a Boeing 707. That's all metal. And I'm not sure if they gave those to executives back in the day or if they were for some kind of advertising. I'm really not sure, but it's pretty cool. Swivels and tilts and everything. I think it's kind of interesting. And then...
you guys might recognize my old motorcycle. This poor thing is my only real failed project that I have. This has been rebuilt 4 or 5 times now, and it never quite ran right or keep breaking stuff, so now it is a decoration. Also, I gave up on it when my triple tree cracked. Mm-hmm. It split pretty good, and I didn't want to shell out the money to fix it, so it sits here.
Yeah, it's actually an SL350. If you look on the channel, you can actually find videos of him riding this. I mean, it used to rev to like, you know, 9,300 RPM, and made pretty decent power, but for a very short amount of time before he blew it up.
Yeah, I basically got one day where it was running great, and then I don't even think we ever filmed it. But it was really fun, and then, yep, it broke again, so now it sits in here.
I mean, we kind of forget, but he actually did a lot of custom work to it, you know, I mean, obviously black painted the engine and wheels, and he bobbed the fender, and, you know, cut the pipes and wrapped
them. Different bars.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are scrambler pipes on it.
It has, like, a Great Escape, you know, like, military-style thing, cover on the headlight there. It also has a 1911 hanging off of it. In case you want to steal anything.
You aren't going to get any of the things here.
And then on the wall here, just general stuff that either one of us has picked up here and there. Scientific America cover, just because we like the, you know, mechanical stuff. It's kind of cool. Monaco posters. Got a couple of them. And then Jordan hung up a couple of my guitars here. This is actually what they call a diddly bow. It's a single string slide guitar style instrument, and it's got Robert Johnson on there. He's sitting at the crossroads with a hellhound behind him. I've got videos of all of this stuff if you want to look at it. And then over here, this is actually a guitar that was signed by Larry the Cable Guy. And that was actually when I presented him with his guitar. He signed this one for me. And I actually have a picture of me and Larry in the other room. We can check that out in a minute here. And then we have a old Dan Electro amp over here. And that's for playing my other slide guitar. That's actually my favorite one. And that one also was a Robert Johnson themed guitar. It's all painted inside and everything. And then some of my artwork on the wall here. That was done quite a few years ago. A little different style than I'm used to doing, but I still kind of like it. And we pick up little things, you know. There's an artist next door to here that did this series here. And he's done some book illustrating and that kind of thing. And then this actually I need to get to my brother. That's his old Pinewood Derby car. And this is one of my old ones there.
You got another one in the
bin. Yeah, and I've got another one in the other room I can show you. And these are just old, you know, I think that might be a Marx, I don't know, old bulldozer, little knickknacks, you know. And I got a PV bass amp here. And kind of a Kramer Focus, which is like a Strat knockoff, basically.
I got you that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and this one, Jordan bought this at Passing Lane Motors from our friend Daryl. And it's got the Studebaker on there, so it's pretty cool. And then right here in the middle of the room is Jordan's homemade coffee table. This is actually the 305 TPI out of the Trans Am. At least we're still using it, kind of. But I guess the Trans Am's ever, if third gen's become worth a ton of money.
I still have it.
You still got it, you can rebuild it.
I've got my original 190 horsepower, whatever, roller block. and four of the pistons.
And, you know, basic little stuff. You know, this is a little cigar box that was decorated up just to hold things.
It's actually over one of my Cobra wheels for the Mustang.
Spare Cobra wheel if anybody needs one.
Very pretty, slightly bent.
Another one of my cigar box guitars. That one's actually decorated with a painting. And the real painting is hanging in the other room. Kind of neat. Jordan's friend bought this 1968 Pontiac GTO. Gave that to him for Christmas after he got his car. Kind of cool. And then more little toys and things. And this is from an artist that he did a lot of drawings for like presidents and that sort of thing. I forget where I picked that up, but it's pretty interesting. You want to flip the painting around here? And it's going to be a long video if we show you all the little stuff. This is the painting that I'm currently working on. The lighting in here is not the best, but it actually has a Ford Model AA, you know, heavy-duty truck. And man's restored a truck just like this, except green, so that's why I chose to use that one.
This also is a, was mine, but is yours now, I suppose. Was a top of a crate from a Don Hardy race motor. Is a 700 horsepower crate LS motor.
Yeah, it was just a crate lid from Mann's again. And then we got various paintings that I've done over the years kind of decorating in here. And someday I actually might get prints made if I can take some good photographs of these and then we can sell the prints, you know. I really don't like getting rid of the originals too much.
This is sort of my editing setup here. I don't remember how big this TV is. I think it's a 40.
No, it's 55.
It's a 55. Yeah, thanks. It's a 55. This is actually a 4K TV.
Mm-hmm.
And it's true 4K. It's, you know, it's not like the whatever they call it.
Yeah.
Interlaced stuff. And then that's a Hewlett Packard computer that's capable of editing 4K. It's a very good computer. It's very new.
Yeah, this thing actually has a lot more RAM than my setup. But we picked it up because we were anticipating going to 4K video, obviously, at some point. We haven't found it to be necessary yet, even though we have the cameras. The camera I'm holding does 4K, but we just haven't found it necessary yet for YouTube.
We just want to be set up so that in the future, whenever everybody starts using 4K, if they do, we're ready. And right now, we can edit any 4K video that we need, and all of our cameras do 4K, too. So, also, it's running on an Xbox One right now. There's actually two Xbox Ones down here, one hooked up to this. And then there's another one over here in the corner hooked up because my friends like to come over sometimes and we'll play video games and things.
We actually found out, and I don't know why, it's kind of odd, but if you can see how this spiral staircase goes up, and it kind of covers over you like a little roof, and you feel like you're sitting like inside of a car or something.
Yeah, it's
And it actually makes the gaming more fun. We both like it.
Yeah. But this actually right here is a Polaroid TV. I don't know if you guys even knew that they made televisions, but that's a Polaroid TV. That one's 1080 by 120 hertz, I think. But
yeah, it's got the high frame rate for gaming and that kind of thing. And actually for gaming, sometimes a small screen is better because your eyes and your mind can take in the whole scene a little bit better than on a giant screen. Yeah. It depends on what you prefer, I guess.
The cool thing is we actually have two Xbox One Live accounts so that if you want to like race somebody on a video game like Forza or whatever, you can have one person there playing on the same Wi-Fi and racing each other online.
And stuff. And they're on two different accounts, so it's pretty cool.
Oh, the Wi-Fi here, by the way, which we didn't really cover, is completely ignorant. I don't know what that's a relative term. I'm sure it's really fast
but
other places.
We have the fastest speed we could get
in town.
Locally. And then we have Blackhawk routers. So there's one actually tucked up in the corner over there. But so you can actually get very high speed even out on the deck outside, so it's pretty fun, you know?
Yeah, me and my girlfriend had a little a barbecue out back. We actually live here. There's two rooms upstairs, but we had a little barbecue out back, and then I drug one of the TVs and an Xbox out there last night, and we were getting, like, pretty fast internet even through the giant brick wall.
Yeah, it's... Oh, and this building was built in the 1850s, and the walls are super thick. So even when it like storms outside, you can't hear anything in here. I mean, it's like a fortress, basically. Here's some more, kind of car artwork that's out of a magazine, obviously, an ad. Then another cigar box guitar hanging up over here by the door. That's a pretty early one, although it does have the frets in it. And Jordan actually built this telescope. It was kind of steampunk style with the brass, and it has like brass chains on it. Kind of interesting, you know?
This isn't super exciting, but since we're doing show and tell, I guess, this is a book I made using stickers from everything I bought for the GTO. But this is basically photos of the car when I got it with all of its VIN codes ran. And then as I was working on it, that's how the engine looked, and that's how it looks now. And then, I just kind of kept it going. And then I have this is all basically receipts for everything that I bought for the car.
Which, if I can give you a piece of advice, don't ever add those up.
No.
He did, and he probably wishes he didn't. But anyway.
I have one of those for the Trans Am, too. And as it turns out, from high school student to adult, that got pretty expensive too.
Over here, just a couple personal things. We actually made this kind of photograph board where we have some of our favorite projects or cars or motorcycles that we've had, that kind of thing. We just kind of put them all up there. You know, it's just kind of interesting to be able to look. That's my old Trans Am there, which is part of the reason that I pushed Jordan into getting one. This actually is my dad's Trans Am. And so it runs in the family, third gen family, basically.
That's not a good thing.
Then this is a painting I did for my dad, which unfortunately my dad's passed away now, so this came back to me. But my dad had a 59 Corvette, so I painted him sitting in that with his little hat that he was kind of famous for wearing there. And then my childhood home that we're going to be selling pretty soon is actually right there. I put it in the painting, so it's kind of neat. But so we'll keep that one forever, obviously.
Yeah, I remember when you gave him that painting. He was like, "Why'd you paint the Corvette red?"
Yeah, Dad's Corvette was white. In fact, I can show it to you here in a minute what it looked like. Now, as we walk through here, you'll notice that there's a bunch of Nerf guns and stuff, and that's because Jordan and his friends basically have giant Nerf wars in here as well.
Listen, I'm a 24-year-old man child, which my girlfriend can attest to.
It's okay, you can walk.
I didn't want to get home.
Somehow a guy that is his age and plays a Nerf gun still has a girlfriend. It's kind of amazing.
She's dressed down right now, which is actually pretty hot. It's confusing. Oh,
that's really nice, kind of, I guess.
Don't call you homely.
Oh, And we got a little artwork from the neighbor guy over there that's an artist. And
Eric is going to think that's so weird.
And then this is actually Eric Lindsay from Man's Restoration. If you'll notice what we did here, we took, what is it called? God, it's God giving life to Adam or something like that. Sorry. I'm having a moment here. I'm old. But anyway, we took Eric Lindsay would be in the God role here, and we replaced Adam. Oh, the creation of Adam is what it's called, honestly, from the Sistine Chapel. And he's actually giving life to a jaguar in this case. But it's just something we made. We thought it was kind of funny. And we actually presented Eric with one that is much larger than this, so he could hang it up in his house. And I'm sure his wife's super happy about it.
She's pretty cool.
You start to see when you walk in here, I can kind of turn a light on maybe, some of the old building here. Like I said, this place was built in the 1850s. So you have these massive brick walls. This would have actually been the outside wall. It was the outside wall. And then all this is add-on afterwards. So, but it's kind of a neat little place, especially for a small town. It's almost like a kind of loft apartment feel. But got a little microwave area here. And every once in a while we just pick up bizarre artwork from other people around. Whatever's interesting, you know.
Eric is trying to quietly make sandwiches.
Mm-hmm. And then this actually is the first painting that I ever did. Well, my first serious painting, I would guess, on canvas. And I gave this to my mom. Of course, she's passed on now. But this actually was painted just freehand. I didn't draw anything. I just painted it. And it wasn't too bad for a real early effort, maybe. Got a little bar sink here. And then this little kitchen, obviously. Erica and Jordan.
Oh, she's gonna kick your ass. Oh no.
Erica and Jordan have, well, they have pictures of Jordan's cars and their pictures and things on here, obviously. And things from trips that they made, like through Georgia and Florida and what have you. And then time slips from the track.
I put that there as a petty response. A couple of my friends were coming over, and they'd been talking a little shit, so I slapped that up there because I know it's quicker than them. It's just me being a man-child, but, you know.
Then Mr. Technology here, Jordan, actually added a little HD monitor here with Chromecast, so you can take your YouTube videos, or like, if Erica wants to, she likes to cook. So, well, it's not because you're a woman, just because you like to cook. Jordan can't cook, but anyway,
I can make some things.
But if she wants to cook, she could actually play a YouTube video of you know, whatever they're doing and send it to the monitor. So it's, I don't know, pretty cool. Or you can just watch whatever you want, obviously. I'm not trying to be sexist, I'm just saying she likes to cook.
You're gonna have to deal with her.
Back here, got a Corvette. Actually, that was bought as a gift for my dad. And got cigar boxes up there.
There's also a bottle of tequila up there for when the Nerf gun battles get a little boring.
Speaking of Nerf gun battles, look at this. He has, and this is only a portion, I'm telling you, he has them all over upstairs as well. It's craziness.
Order them online
because
I'm a dork. This is weird though, because when I was a toddler in the 90s, he came home with one just like this, and this was actually one of the first Nerf guns I ever owned. This isn't it though. I rebought this on the internet because I'm a complete dweeb.
And we later modified it
with the cartridge,
so that it would, instead of shooting a big dart, it shot a smaller one, but much harder. So it was kind of cool. But anyway, speaking of Nerf guns, when we were getting ready to do this video today, I actually thought to drag this out off the shelf because I thought you might find this interesting. It's actually called Jumpstart Your Brain, and it's by a guy named Doug Hall. And Doug Hall was like just a creative genius behind a lot of the best marketing campaigns out there. I don't know if he's still doing it today. This is back in the 90s probably, that he was in his heyday. But he said that he has a proven method for increasing creativity up to 1,500%, I think it is. But what I thought was kind of interesting in here is that he actually had a place called Eureka Mansion. And what he would do is he would have his people there, but then he would also have executives from the marketing departments of these major corporations, and they would come to Eureka Mansion and they would basically brainstorm and come up with ideas to market their products. And one thing he believed was that having some fun actually increases creativity. So at Eureka Mansion, he had like an off-road go-kart course, pinball machines, several cases of silly string, a mountain of Play-Doh, plenty of bubble pipes, an arsenal of Nerf toys, and high-powered squirt guns. So, you know, Jordan's Nerf guns may not be that silly after all, because, you know, playing around with toys like that every once in a while kind of breaks things up and keeps you creative, keeps the plasticity of your mind, and it can actually result in you coming up with some interesting ideas.
Actually, the Google headquarters, they do it too.
Yeah, Google, they have like tennis courts and basketball courts and all these common areas, and yeah, so there's some, you know, some thought put into that. Actually, interestingly enough, along those same lines, I actually learned how to juggle out of this book, and it's hard to believe you can learn how to juggle out of a book, but you really can. And I just followed this method step by step, and I can juggle pretty decently now. And what's so funny is this is a business and marketing book, but that's where I learned how to juggle. So, you know, I don't know. Obviously, there's people that are more creative, but maybe some of the stuff does help with the ideas for paintings or videos or whatever, you know. But so it's also just fun, you know. But sometimes taking a break and just having a little fun, exercise is also proven to help your creativity. So, you know, maybe having the weights and the treadmill and everything in here is a good idea. So
yeah, actually drawing, general art, stuff like that, that's good too. If you, if you're an artistic person or a creative person, doing stuff along those lines can help you out quite a bit.
But anyway, we just thought we'd throw that in there for you. Maybe put a little reason behind Jordan's giant Nerf gun collection. And not that he's just a big giant nerd.
Hey,
but anyway,
this big giant nerd still builds cars. Leave me alone. We haven't even shown them all the real guns that are hidden around.
Yeah, there's a bunch.
There's like 20 firearms in this building.
And we got Muhammad Ali here with an old vintage set of boxing gloves. And then actually over here, Jordan hung up this picture of my dad lifting weights back in the day. This is back in East St. Louis. He was a pretty strong dude for the 50s, you know. He actually lived in that old shack. I mean, my dad didn't have any money when he was growing up. And that's basically what he lived in, just like a little shack with a wood burner in it. And his friends used to joke that there was a couple times they came over, and in the winter, it was so cold that my dad would wash up in a pan of water, and he would have to break the ice off the water to wash up. So that tells you what that was like, you know.
When he was my age, he lived in that, and my life's a little better, easier, I would guess.
I'll tell you something, though. Dad, through hard work alone, went from living in that little shack to owning a 59 Corvette that was less than a year old. He bought it at the time. Actually, I have a picture of the car over there we can show you in just a second. But, you know, just little neat things. Jordan found this trunk here at a local place that buys up estates and sells them. And that's actually a real steamer trunk that would come on a steamship, or that you would take on a steamship. It even has a logo on the back that looks like the Titanic.
The logos are really cool, but they're hard to see.
And, you know, like it has, you can pull these out, and you pull all your hangers out here. It's pretty neat. And these are all obviously like dresser drawers, but they lock. And we actually found notes in there from scuba dives this guy was making. So that was pretty interesting. So you kind of know some of the places it was. Yeah, he tells you about the conditions and the weather and how deep he was diving, that kind of thing. Pretty neat.
There's a lot of fastback Mustang memorabilia sitting around yeah. here. We don't have one, neither of us. That'll probably change at some point.
Yeah, 67 GT500, got to have one of them eventually. This thing, I'm just going to tell you, maybe we'll do a review some other day, but they're pretty pricey, but if you can afford one, I would recommend getting one. These things are awesome. It's called a JBL Boombox. It's got a massive like lithium battery in there, and it can play for 24 hours straight, and that thing just cranks, so you wouldn't believe. And you can, if you have the guts, you can actually throw that thing in the pool because it's completely waterproof. So, I mean, and Jordan actually carries that from car to car. because he prefers it to the stereos he has in his cars, you know?
Yeah, that's actually better than my Mustang stereo, and GTO has no stereo, so if I want to listen to music, bring that.
At the time, I was like, it seemed like a pretty, like, kind of extravagant purchase. I'm like, man, you might regret that. But he uses it all the time. I mean, he carries it out on the deck. He's got a little deck out here. It actually wraps all the way around the back of the building. You feel like you're kind of walking on the deck of a ship out there or something.
There's still beer bottles outside. Is there?
Jordan just had a barbecue, so.
Whatever.
Got a homemade bow that I made back there out of a tree that got hit by lightning, kind of like the natural. And this amazing artwork is Jordan's from high school. It's a, I don't know, abstract is what I would call it. I like to call it teenage angst. He was like angry at the time, and I think he was like, black.
I don't remember what the story is on that. I think I might have had an art project due, and it was an abstract art project. So I just, I ripped, this was a paint by numbers thing I picked up, and I just ripped it off and just went like this and turned it in.
There's something that I like about it. He doesn't think we should have it hung up here, but I think it's really cool.
I like that you put the Japanese festival thing on there, because you see that way.
Yeah, it's kind of a Japanese style thing, you know?
I didn't think that was what I was going for at the time, but all right.
Then in here, it's kind of like a little workout area, gaming area, that kind of thing.
This is just a screw-around room.
Yeah, a little bit of everything.
Yeah.
Bunch of my folk paintings on the wall from over the years, you know. You can actually, if you know where to start, you can kind of look at them and see them progress where they're not as good at first. And I was kind of like figuring it out as I went, because nobody taught me anything. I just learned how to do it, you know. Treadmill here actually got picked up out of the trash. It wasn't working. A friend of mine threw it out. And
he doesn't know you have that.
Oh, I told him later.
Okay.
But I saw it. We picked it up, and then we actually rewired it and made it work, and got a couple thousand miles on it so far, and works out really well. The spin bike here actually is my brother bought this, so this is on loan from him. When he moved, I asked if we could borrow it and have it over here, because that way, like, I don't know. You can be working, you can come in here, ride the bike, watch TV for a little bit, and get a little bit of exercise, although we both need a little more, probably.
I've lost 20 pounds, but it's not enough.
Working on it,
yeah.
You know. Jordan keeps this old TV, like, just for some nostalgia's sake. He used to play games on that back in the day, like on the first Xbox days, things like that. So he won't get rid of it. And he actually has other like LCD LED TVs that could go here, but he just likes having that old thing, and it's it still works, which is
even out why I really have it.
Why do you really have it?
When I run on the treadmill, I watch shows like Gold Rush and like Fast and Loud, and then when people pop up, I practice shooting sticky darts.
That is the honest to God truth. He really does do that. It's more like Nerf training. Pretty sad.
Yeah, it's not cool, but whatever.
Anyway, it still works, man. Stereo. Then we have another E-Machines computer here. Xbox games. We had some little relics from the YouTube. This up here, I guess I don't really have to get it down, but you guys might have seen this on our channel. It's a boat made out of a foam board. That's what they call a pop-pop or a putt-putt boat, where it runs basically on steam power. We have a couple videos on this channel, and YouTube is weird, and believe, this is not to brag in any way, because we've made hundreds of videos that made no money, but some stuff is just weird. This thing, there's two videos of it, and that little thing that was made for like 10 bucks made us thousands of dollars. It's crazy what takes off. Like, it's the hardest thing to figure out. Another such item is this thing. And okay. That's kind of why we keep them.
Yeah, I made this when I was probably too old to be making stuff like this still, but that's fine.
This thing has hundreds of thousands of views, and all it is a homemade shotgun he made to shoot rubber bands.
Yeah, it's a little busted up, but you'd put the rubber band on this and then hook it in that little clothespin, and then it would stretch back here, and when you pull the trigger, that would move forward, and it would shoot the rubber band. It actually worked pretty well. But
just the fact that it looked like a pump shotgun, I guess. And again, the thing has brought in thousands and thousands of dollars. It's the weirdest thing. But then you'll fill in stuff that you think is just amazing, and it won't make hardly anything. So it's like, you know, YouTube's weird like that, you know?
this isn't supposed to be a shrine, but it kind of looks like one.
Yeah.
We were bringing stuff home from Grandma and Grandpa's house, and we didn't really know where to put anything. So I just kind of started stacking it up on the fireplace, because the fireplace doesn't, I'm not supposed to be using that. But it has kind of turned into a small shrine with their rings and things. That's actually a piston out of the 305, by the way.
Yeah, we got like my mom and Jordan here. This is my dad with Jordan and Jordan's cousin Tony. And some pictures of mom. And my dad's like Elvis glasses that he wore.
I used to ride by on the school bus when I was in grade school. And well, probably honestly until I was almost out of school. And he would hold that in the window when I went by. He was always up real early.
And then over here, this is going on and on, but this actually is my dad's 59 Corvette. Like I said, he bought that in 1960, so it had just a few miles on it when he bought it. And we actually have a loan contract here from when he borrowed a little money to buy it, and he paid it off in just like a couple of years, you know, just working regular jobs. This is me and Larry the Cable Guy when he got his guitar, and like I said, he signed that other one.
Man, kissed you on the cheek.
Yeah. And then this is my dad's like 30-year retirement, and he has one from 25, 30, and he actually worked beyond 30.
But yeah, he was very petty, and he didn't want to work beyond 30, but they made him, and he actually wrote down the final date on that.
Yeah, so he wrote it in there. It's kind of funny. He wanted full credit for what he did. That actually is a clock that you get from Ford at 30 years. You get that sweet clock.
He used to complain about all the kids, stupid little knickknacks I gave.
We do have like tons of weight plates in here.
I have a dartboard hung up.
And then you can tell who's the boss, because Erica's bike is sitting right here inside out of the weather. Meanwhile, Jordan's is on the other side of that window on the deck out in the rain.
Her bike is awesome. It's actually got a beer bottle opener here. And then
It's a
little parrot horn.
Margaritaville themed bike. So it's got a parrot, you know, if you're a Jimmy Buffett fan. But yeah, I like the bottle opener. It's pretty cool. It even has a parrot embossed into the chain guard too, which is pretty awesome.
People around here go on like I forget what they call the things, but they like basically ride from bar to bar, a group of women.
Yeah.
And they'll drink at each bar. Men do it too. And
kind of a booze cruise.
Booze cruise thing, but on bicycles instead of like a poker run on Harleys. And
generally
stuff.
To raise money for charities.
You know. And I had one of them almost fall in front of me the other day. So tanked up. But we go on bike rides. There's a bike trail down the street, so.
Set of golf clubs. Got a old Bob Ross over here. Says ever make mistakes in life. Let's just make them birds. Yeah, they're birds now. So.
Erica got me that for my birthday. Oh, I got this sweet blow dart gun for the dartboard. If you're brave enough.
That thing shoots really hard. Like you definitely. If you're so inclined, it would kill a small animal.
Yeah.
In fact, when he shoots them to the dartboard, it's kind of hard to dig them out sometimes because it hits so hard. But yeah, I mean, I guess, you know, got the heavy bag here, but I guess that's about it, you know. But we thought we'd give you a little look around because we've never done that before here.
She's eating outside. She didn't want to be rude.
But we thought, you know, since we passed 100,000 subscribers, we'd give you a little look around the office set up here, and obviously he's got a couple bedrooms, a couple bathrooms upstairs and all that, but
the
that's
bedrooms are pretty cool. There's as a rough overview, there's actually a 40 in our main bedroom, the one that we sleep in, and the other one's another office guest bedroom. Nobody stays in it, but there's a 40 over here in ours and a 40 over here. There's PS4 and then whatever over here so that we can play games upstairs too because we're dorks. Bed, and there's a bathroom with a shower, and then the little room next to it's got a 40-inch TV on the wall, and a small bed, like a really small bed, and then it's got a bathroom over in the corner too, and that room is full of guns, but that's about it.
Yeah, this is not the place to break into, that's for sure. Not to mention it's right next door to the police station.
Yeah, which for a guy with loud cars is probably not the...
It's a good thing they're friends with us, though.
Super cool people.
Mm-hmm.
Very lenient. Yeah, you might have to contend with a 15-year-old hunting dog that's afraid of firearms if you break in here.
Yeah, he's pretty vicious, man. Yeah, I don't know.
He's actually pretty tough, but he's not so tough anymore.
He's hanging in there. There's another Monaco poster that we didn't show yet. But, yeah, I guess that's about it. We just thought this place was cool at the time because it's like, this is a very small town, 900 people. So you can imagine that finding a place with kind of a city feel to it, you know, kind of like a loft apartment type thing, is hard to find around here. So it was something that couldn't be passed up, basically.
This isn't really meant to be a braggy video. There are people that have much cooler stuff than this. We just wanted to show it off a little bit. This is in Illinois, obviously. We don't really know if we're going to be staying in Illinois permanently. We've been considering moving to Missouri. So all of this might get packed up and then moved into another place down there, might build a place down there. We have no idea, but we just kind of wanted to shoot a quick video to show everything before we do anything like that. We also might stay here indefinitely, so we have no clue.
we got, right now we're kind of stuck here at the moment. My dad, when he passed away, left us a couple houses to deal with, which is, you know, not a chore, it's just something to deal with.
It's a bit of a chore.
So they have to be cleaned up, fixed up, all that before they can be sold or whatever. So we're really kind of chained down here for a little while until all that gets settled, and then we can figure out what to do next.
Remodeling houses is time consuming.
Oh, yeah.
It takes a while.
Doing that and trying to keep up with the videos and the photography and everything, it's a lot to do, you know. But, anyway, we just thought we'd give you a look around. Like I said, we just wanted to show you like a little behind the scenes, like where we actually work. I mean, this is legitimately where the videos get done, either here or over there. And just thought we'd kind of show you what we're working with here.
My friend John with the Mustangs is online.
Yeah. But, I mean, YouTube's been fun. I mean, it's, like I said, 9 years now. Started in 2010. And I don't know. It's been a lot of fun. We made a lot of videos. It's a fun way to make a living because we get to drive cool cars, get to be around cool people. Man's Restoration. It's fun to hang out there and see those guys work because they do amazing work.
We don't really talk about that place because most of our videos are just 3 minute either music videos or we're just showing a finished car. But like all those guys at Man's are cool. There's not one guy there that's like a dick or anything.
No, it's like a big family, man.
Yeah,
it's really
cool.
And same with Country Classic Cars, man. There's some great people up there. They have hundreds and hundreds of cars, so like it's pretty endless. We're actually increasing what we're doing with them right now. So you'll see more videos from there. Also, Man's, look forward to stuff that's more like a television show. It took a while to get to it, but we're going to get away from the music type videos a bit and start doing like interviews with the guys or not really interviews, but videos where they show us them doing the work and kind of explain what they're doing. So that'll be pretty exciting. And we may add another place here or there. We don't know, but we'll just kind of take it as we go here. But like I said, fun way. And we've met a lot of cool people on YouTube. Obviously, I can't name everybody off the top of my head. But go to our channel. Check out our favorite channels list. You know, people like 805 Road King. People like Murray from Paradox Designs. Sam Space. Sam Malo down in Texas. He's awesome.
Invincible Extremes. Mm-hmm. There's a lot.
Captain John. Just tons of people. George the Shade Tree Fix-It Man. Like I said, there's literally, we could list and list and list people.
There's a pretty good group of guys on there that are all really cool. And I know we're, as soon as we finish this, we're going to think of about 20 more that we should have said, but you know who you are.
Cause we comment on your stuff too.
Yeah.
But like Road King, I'm telling you, Road King comes to mind because me and him have been, talking to each other since 2010. I mean, right away we linked up and we kind of like would send people back and forth to each other's channel. There's another guy named Groudawan Clayton that did that up in Canada. He's an awesome guy. Yeah, that guy had some skills, man.
He's more talented as far as making stuff.
Oh, he can build some cool stuff. But anyway, guys, we just wanted to give you a quick look around. More so, we're just celebrating getting the 100,000 subscriber thing from YouTube. That was a big goal of ours, 100,000 subscribers and 100 million views. That was the two giant goals. We had no idea if we'd ever reach it or how long it would take. We're happy to knock one down, and we're sitting at about 75.5 million views right now. So, 100 million should happen if we just keep plugging along, you know. That's kind of what we do. It's nothing we don't do anything amazingly better than anyone else or anything like that. We just keep plugging along, doing the work.
They
you
printed
know.
This on cardstock.
Oh, yeah.
Fancy.
We have to frame that, too.
Yeah.
But anyway, guys, this is really just rambling. Jordan's right back to the couch where it all began.
I've had this couch for like 7 years.
Anyway, thank you to everybody that supports our channel. Thank you for watching and subscribing. Thank you for all the comments, everything like that. We do appreciate it. If you didn't support us, we wouldn't be able to do any of this. You know, it's just it's one of those things. It built real slowly over time, but we're finally getting to where you know, it pays the bills and we can build a few kind of cool projects. And
neither one of us have day jobs anymore.
And I will tell you this, the plan, we've probably said this before, but the ultimate plan has always been to build a new shop where we can build cool stuff. We're working towards that plan. We're saving up. Like I said, we got to tie up this family stuff with the houses and all that. Once all that's sold and settled and everything, then we can move on. And we'll probably have some cool stuff coming, you know.
My GTO get faster. Trans Am get faster. Your cars will run someday. Yeah.
Lots of cool stuff on the horizon. Anyway, I think that is plenty. I have no idea how long this is, but I'm sure very long.
About an hour.
Yeah. But, again, we thank you guys. We appreciate it. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye.
You waiting on me to say bye?
Sure.
Bye.
This is the kind of professionalism you get after 9 years. All right, guys. We did hang it up on the wall here. And we actually decided, you'd think, put it out in the open where everybody could see it, but we thought maybe under the staircase there, it would have a little bit of added protection from the Nerf gun wars.
You make it sound like that's all I do. I work on cars all the time, too. God.
Hey, it is an issue. It's not like it's not an issue. He actually has to throw blankets over the paintings and everything so that they don't get Nerf gunned to death.
These things shoot hard. I figured out how to make it shoot multiples. This little thing actually shoots pretty hard. This one hurts.
Wow, that is pretty hard.
Yeah, for a kid's toy. I don't think I would give like a 7-year-old that.
You can also hold down the trigger and...
Yeah. This one would not feel good. Let me make it shoot a couple at a time. Ah, me and my nerdy hobbies.